Did you want to join the game, or are you watching the stream?
I'm watching the stream while I play some Horizon Zero Dawn.
Okay. So, who's playing, Ox?
On Ox side, another map by Freakling, we have Babel.
Oh, and we have Bakuryu.
Yes.
CBC. Okay.
And he's thankful for these show matches because he doesn't get to play foreigners apparently much. Bakuryu.
Foreigners? What do you mean? Bakuryu isn't German?
I think what I thought he meant was he didn't get to play people outside of maybe Europe much.
Oh.
So he's grateful for the opportunity to play.
Toon Red sucks. I play with Alm, for example, on many of my partners down in RK, and it sucks because we have a terrible lag. Even though when IRK plays South American teams, they always complain about the lag. So it's really unfortunate because I think we could have like good training partners, but these latency issues keep us playing with only people who lives all the countries who lives nearby. So that really sucks. I don't like when I play with versus people from Chile or from Bolivia, even from Peru. Some Peruvians don't like. For example, Terror, I play 24 TR low. And Peru isn't that nearby from Argentina.
Right.
But when I play versus European,
with the lag.
Yeah, that really sucks because we could have so much better games. So I must confess that I know nothing about CBC. So strategically wise, I cannot give any input or output to this game.
You're a Terran user, so it's more or less the same. I mean, there's not much you guys can offer. Public complaints.
Yeah, I can complain about Zerg being the best race and being broken. So maybe I can dedicate myself of saying why Zerg is the best race. And why they should and why they should make the filers, but it will be unfair for our two foreign stars.
You have battle cruisers, man. They have a defiler. They can't even attack.
Battle cruisers are the worst unit. They die with two plagues and one spore.
Maybe.
You know that I'm right. So Babo chose a 12 hatch, which is pretty cool. And Bakuryu did a safer opener with pull first. I'm not really sure what is best. I would believe that 12 hatch is a better choice. But for me, Zerg versus Zerg is about getting your mutas in time and not dying versus a bunch of links and microing. So it's really micro intensive battles where if you lose a drone, your life is over. You break out. You just break out with your girlfriend, you know. So you really have to take care of your stuff in CBC, I believe.
Well, Babo just lost at least one drone.
Yeah, so his wife is leaving him. I know it. He knows it. So layer timings are almost the same. Drone count is the same. The only difference is that Bakuryu has a sunken, which it hasn't morphed yet. So it's safe to say that this game is pretty much even, like, even though they start in doing different builds. Babo has more Zerling. He has 10 Zerling versus 3 of Bakuryu. That's the difference. So maybe
Yeah, back invested in some drones.
Yeah, and a sunken. So
here comes the links.
Yeah, so maybe Bakru have a really hard time because there's nothing to defend, for example, a Sarling Rambai. And I don't think that he will be able to stop this. I don't think one sunken will stop 12 links with speed. So a really, 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 really questionable choice by Bakru. Let's see.
You know, he's just unlucky that his links are just making. And wasn't able to block off the ramp.
Yeah, so now he's dealing...
Gonna lose the Spire, maybe.
Or even worse, he will lose like 4 drones there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the Spire, so yep. This is a GG. What a bad choice for Bakru, who made, I think, too many drones. Even though he lost like 7 drones, they are even now. But the bad news for Bakru is that he lost his Spire. So no Spire, no birthday party for you.
He saw the links coming too. I guess you might call that a little bit greedy.
Yeah, too greedy for a Zerg versus Zerg. So I'm expecting a GG anytime now. Only 2 mutas. So I don't know how he's gonna stop, and I think we both know.
Yeah. He canceled his evolution chamber, the first one he made. Too. So the second one is delaying the spore.
Even though he has spores, we all know Babos Mural is micro, so this game will not go the distance. GG.
Yeah, that's too bad.
Well, I think it was a great mistake.
He had a nice little setup there.
Yeah,
but he clearly saw Babu was making links there. Very few drones.
Well, he should have scouted, though. But well, I don't know. I think Bakru knows better than me.
Everybody knows better than Terrence. Even I know better.
We are masters in StarCraft knowledge.
Complaints. Fantasies.
That too. Complaints, maybe. But
I've heard this before. I actually thought my opponent was smarter than he was. So you can lose a game and say that you're smarter than your opponent.
Oh yeah, of course. I'm not going to reveal his identity, but after losing a match, a Protoss user told depleted, I'm an engineer, what are you? And he left the game. A really good and well known Protoss user. That whose identity I will not reveal because
but look, we got an engineer on our team, so
No.
I will say. Go to the unemployment insurance office to find where the Terrence is.
I will say that it's a S rank Protoss player, known in the community, cried and say, "I'm an engineer."
I wonder if he uses that on the ladies. He says, "Hey girl, I'm an engineer. What are you? Are you a lady or a man?"
I really don't know.
It might work better there.
But when he pleaded told me, I really cracked and laughed.
StarCraft really does test your, especially when you're playing at a high level. I guess with anything in life, right? You develop an ego.
But yeah, they But yeah, he has a history in complaining. But I have to say one thing that I value very much. A few days later, he wrote to depleted and asked him and said sorry to him because
history. I mean, that's
so
nice.
that's a thing I value very much. So
the human conscience.
Yeah, it was hilarious, but I value as well. That thing. So really props to him, because you can be mad, but it takes a man to admit that you were wrong and you were angry. So I really like that from him.
Taking those losses, I mean, that's humbling experience. Very few people could take it.
Well,
with their chin up and be a sportsman about it, you know, like, yeah, good game, well played.
Well, it depends on how you take the game. I think if you play in a more competitive level, the game means more to you than if you played for fun. So
you're in professional sports, right? And I mean, I'm assuming maybe you've lost once at least.
I never lost.
Do you also? Okay, maybe you say that you lost.
Okay, one. If I would.
Well, I guess it doesn't work if you really haven't, but it's like, how do you handle, you know, that?
No, we.
If you never play competitively, then you've never lost once.
Yeah.
Fact.
Hypothetically, if I lose a game, I will be really mad. But it depends. It depends. It depends on the people. It depends on the culture. For example, in Argentina,
you mean StarCraft. I mean, nobody's delighted.
No,
to lose,
in Argentina, no, in Argentina, we are really passionate people. It's like we have.
But you still fight the urge of saying you fucking whatever.
No, not always.
Human being.
Not always.
Do you GG and leave?
No.
Sometimes you don't GG.
Yes, I only
even if they didn't BM or do anything. Well, that's normal.
No,
I GG.
If I know him, I always GG. That's and if I really think they play good, I don't GG.
There you go. These are the Terrans. They have.
I don't do courtesy GGs. So if he played good, because I don't know if you.
And that's up to a Terran to decide.
Not for me to decide. It's my opinion. I'm not invoking.
The game decides committee. When it says Pato has been eliminated.
Yeah, but the game doesn't decide. Hey, Pato's enemy did a good game. Well played.
Ah. You're in the corner building a supply depot, and then you. You cancel its construction, so it's not like fully made.
If he makes like an all in, and I forget a supply. If he made a 5-pool, and I didn't scout it earlier. If it was something cheesy like that, I don't really GG to all ins. Because
what if they just Zerg rush you?
It depends. If it's an aggressive play,
I get what you mean. Yeah.
Because not everything is all in. If you play an aggressive Zerg, it's okay, IGG. But if you like do a build order that is flipping a coin and expecting me to not scout in time, sometimes you have like a 1/3, like 33% chance you don't see it in time, and you really hope for him to don't be a kamikaze and throw like a cheesy bill order, and sometimes they do, and you have the bad luck that they were in the last spot you scouted and they won, and that's a bill order that works only with luck, because if I scout it, if I go to that position to scout it, I would have seen it, and so that's not a good game. That's a cheesy game you do to earn some points. So if you play for to improve and you play better,
right?
Okay,
I mean, that's our closest point, and it has a lot of validity there. But you know, competition just lends itself to just wanting to win sometimes.
Yeah,
so
but
I think understanding the nature of competition.
Yeah, but ladder is not a tournament. So for example,
in a win and lose culture, you know.
If I'm playing a Korean pro gamer, a Korean knows that you're going to all in him since he's really better than you. So I don't know. I think he expects the on-lean.
Listen, Bax plus one isn't completely done, but it's way ahead of Babos. Plus one.
Plus one in Carapace, yeah. So, yeah.
I have.
But I don't know who has more mutas, to be honest. No, they have both 11 mutas. So, this will be a micro battle. But I think Babo will win it because plus one isn't finished.
Oh my god.
Yep. Wow.
Big difference here.
Big difference, yeah. So Babo took that fight like seconds after the plus one ended, so that was really good. And that would really gave Bakuru an edge to win that fight, but Babo too strong. Interesting.
Did that deserve a GG?
Yeah, of course, it was really nice Mira Micro. Depleted did a tutorial, and I stream it live, all the details. And I really learned a lot of things about Mira Micro that I didn't know. Like, when do you use attack, patrol, or hold position, and the difference that it make. For example, with patrol, all the mutas attack one unit. With hold position, they like divide the damage with all the units that are near. So maybe if you have like six mutas, you can use patrol because they will focus all the damage on one marine and they will insta kill it. But if you have 12 mutas, it's better to spread the damage because if you use 12 mutas to snipe a marine, it will the damage will not be spread and you wouldn't use your mutas efficiently. So it was really nice. It was I learned a lot from that and how to micro it properly. So
as a Terran user against Zerg.
Yeah.
So you're using that knowledge.
Well, I learned a lot. Yeah, it really helped me, even me as Terran, to know how Zergs use their mutalisk. Even though I cannot use them, like, obviously.
Who invited you to that tutorial?
No, I asked because we have a Argentinian community, and Depleted was kind enough to teach.
You should have kicked you out, man. No Terrans allowed.
I streamed it, so it could be recorded. And all the people who couldn't be there could watch it later. Because you know how is it. If you stream it on Discord, some people will arrive 20 minutes late and start doing questions, and maybe questions that he already answered. So it's better to stream it, record it, so he can say all the information he wants. And if you have any doubts, you can watch the stream and then make the questions, right? If you didn't catch it on time. Got it, sorry, on time. So it was really nice. It takes a lot of practice, but what I wanted to go with all that is that obviously Babo has an outstanding mutant micro, and it's... Microing Mutalisk versus Scourge is the most difficult micro in the game. Winning that battle, you have to acknowledge the level and the practice that took Babo to really move his Mutalisk in that way, even though with lag. So I don't think it was luck. I think Babo knows how to control his muta like few Zergs can. So that's why I would say GG. They have the exact amount of mutalisk, and Babo lose like half of the mutas and kill them all, and kill all the enemy mutas. So that's pretty insane, in my opinion.
Right. Yeah. I didn't see that coming out. Back is getting a lair before Babo is making more links.
And... yeah, so that's not particularly bad. Because if you make your lair afterwards, you can still be aggressive with links. I don't know if how good your micro with link is, but maybe you have to make a line, or like a barrier of links in the ramp, in order for have a better arc. Mm-hmm. But I think Babo has way more links, so maybe like 10-15 seconds before that spire finishes, he will attempt to break that ramp. And I think he will, to be honest, because he has more links there, and he has even 4 more links back in his ramp. So, yeah. Even though Bakuri of Mutas will be back in time, I think Babo really has a shot in this game. So we'll have to see. I don't know, Ox, if you saw Flash matches when he played random.
Some of them, yeah.
You remember the match versus Queen where he got Zerg, and he played Zerg versus Zerg? Right. In papers, you saw Flash getting way more faster Mutalisk because he did like a 9 pull, and Queen did a 12 hatch. So I think he even didn't have a lair, but Queen didn't allow Flash to do any damage with his mutas because the amount of links that he got keep Flash mutas on his base. So
that's interesting. Good memory.
Yeah. It's Flash game.
The Terran player.
Oh, Flash is a god. He's the fourth race.
Scan was telling me he noticed that none of the people he was playing against were Terran users. So they were all picked because they were Protoss and Zerg.
Sorry?
Scan was just pointing out that all his opponents were non-Terran players. They're Protoss and Zerg users. I'm not sure what Scan's point was. Maybe that was just the point of the opponents. They weren't any Terran users, right? They were all Protoss and Zerg.
In where? Here in
the Flash is random.
Oh yeah. He's right. Yes, he's right because I was really disappointed as well, Scan. I was really looking forward to see like Light or someone like that playing versus random, because many questions that popped after that show match is how they will play against a random user, which is the best build order, for example, for a Protoss. So for Protoss, many players propose to do a one pylon, one gateway outside the natural. So that's a good build order against Zerg, like a standard. It's a okay build order versus Terran because you can be aggressive with the Zealot, and it's not good PvP, but it's playable, right? So and versus Zerg as well, what do you do as a Zerg user? You do like a pull first, 12 pull, 11 pull, you do a 12 hatch. So seeing a pro gamer approach that kind of games, it was really a good lesson for us. For all the people who watched that match, and there were non-Terran users, so Scan is right. I was really disappointed. I was really looking forward to see slash PBT or CBT as well.
Well, as a Terran user, you should be used to disappointment.
What format, sorry?
I just meant playing Terran is just full of disappointments.
Oh, yeah. It's a hard life being Terran, but it's really, it's worth it.
Oh, it's, it's
worth it. At the end of the day, I remember that I don't play Protoss.
Oh, you got two drones. Oh, yeah. I kind of walked through Babu's mutas there. I was kind of wondering why doesn't one of them go on the offensive? Because then you just get aggression advantage there. And you can sort of dictate, you know, whether you're attacking the main or...
Well, natural. when you have lag as well, you have to get used to micro in a different way, because your responding time has different timings. So your muta micro is going to be different.
Oh, look at this. He just found the perfect time to go into Babo's base. But he wasn't attacking the drones. Those 2 seconds there?
Yeah.
He got a bunch of drones. This looks bad for Babo.
Yeah, really? It does. I think he has,
I can't see him coming back for this.
Yeah, he has less mutas. Oh, yeah. He's going to lose his battle. 5 mutas versus 2. 2 mutas versus 4. GG. Okay. That was unfortunate for him. GG.
Babo's mutas were kind of in the center, right? You leave your base for a few seconds and...
Yeah, but over. I believe he has a... I don't think he has the same amount of mutalisk.
Grains of Sand. So this map, I wasn't supposed to select because the map author called it a bug fest, but they played on it and they didn't have any complaints.
He has a racer, like a load. What the fuck?
It's a beta version, so it hasn't been finalized yet.
It seems like the, you know, the racer, the brand. These new maps, Ox, have a lot of copyrights issues, dude. If the police comes, I will not.
Yeah, we both refer to...
I will not testify. Jerry. Yeah. I will not testify to this. You know that map has a Charmander in the middle of the map?
Yeah.
You know the police will come to my house, and I will say, I no hablo inglés.
Does he really have a Charmander in the middle of the map?
Yeah, that's a copyright there. Yeah. Copyright
if
infringement.
If it's accepted, I mean, they could always ask him
so,
to.
So, you know, if the FBI comes to my house, I would say, no hablo inglés, buen señor. creo que un amigo, Jerry.
I heard they are cracking down the American whatever department is responsible for it. Because during COVID, a lot of people have been accessing free content online.
Oh, really?
Like movie sites and stuff. Yeah, they just cracked. I don't know what website or whatever it was.
Let us be. It's quarantine. We have to see new movies. Let us be. Yeah, you cannot. You have to make our life easier. So we cannot go out.
They lose a lot of money that way, right? But I guess my thing is the people who watch that usually don't spend money, so.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they will do the impossible to not spend money. And they usually call the people who does suckers. Oh, you pay for that? Ha ha ha. I watch it for free.
But the assumption here is that the people who are watching it would have spent the money. But the problem is sometimes I would only want to watch a movie if it's free. Otherwise I would not want to watch it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I can see the issue with that, right? How would you like it if, you know, you put in all that work and produce something and it's being accessed for free?
Well, they already pay for it. For example, it's not like the actors and the people who made that movie didn't get paid. They want millions. It's like if I'm a constructor guy and I build your bathroom, I will claim, hey, how you're still using the bathroom I built for you? Okay, you build it, I paid you. It's okay. I don't have to pay you rent because you build my bathroom. So.
Are these the arguments we're going to present when we're in jail?
Yeah.
Well, there's
I'm not a lawyer.
Argument is that pirating, you, I'm not taking the one and only copy. I'm just making another copy of it. I'm not stealing it, because when you steal somebody's, like, I don't know, fruit basket, their fruit basket is gone. But when you pirate something, you just make a second fruit basket.
Why don't we just, like, go back to and ask it, like, what is pirating it?
Yeah, and that's, you know, and that's how we ended in jail.
I love when Homer's in jail and Lionel Hutz is like, I have surprise witnesses, one after the next.
Yeah.
And then Chief Wiggum knocking down there. Pipe down, Hutz, and he's in jail in there with...
Lionel Hutz is the best character ever. Phil Hartman played it. He was a god. Yeah. So, I don't know why these two players are going with one base Muralisk, but again, I'm not a Zerg versus Zerg specialist. But it really seems that, it seems that Babo has an upper hand if he can hold these Starlings. He has two more drones and Spire on the way. And I don't know about Valkyrie's option, maybe doing like a full Ling and trying to breach on Babo's base. But he has already his Ling's position in the ramp, so I think we're going to see a fast GG here. I don't think that doing an Aspire is the most brilliant option from our German friend. I think he has to do like an all-in with the Darlings, but in this particular moment, the Spire of Babel already finished. Mutas are on their way, and poor Yellow Zerg is running out of options. So yeah. All Starlings are dead. GG for Babo, and he takes it home 3-1, right?
You got it.
Okay, so Latin American power. Yeah.